Hey guys, Zolan here, back again with another review, and today we are continuing Gargoyles Week with one of our last figures, the second last figure, and that is the Steel Clan Robot. Now, the Steel Clan Robot actually has been made into Xanatos Customs, and I personally can't blame him. He looks more like Goliath than that other thing. I mean, you're gonna quick size compare. I'm gonna take his freaking wings off. He's too daggum big to fit in the set with his wings. As he frickin' takes him out. How does that work? Goliath was in front of you, numbnuts. Oh yeah, he comes with a gun. You got a tail, brah. Why are you falling over? But, yeah, Goliath seems to be a lot taller than I thought. How does that work? I don't know. Goliath seems to be floppy-doppy McDoofenheim when he's not. Fully assembled. We already looked at him, so I just thought I'd throw him in for the size comparison. Why? You want to go back on? There we go. But the thing that fell out of the Steel Clan robot's hand was the little gun, which we'll look at now, actually, right after we bring in another quick size comparison. Coldstone. Yeah, of course he's taller. We already did that. we'll be having a look at him last. Actually, we'll be looking at the bike last, but here's the gun. You know, I tried to use this with frickin' Demona. She does not hold anything, so screw her, right? but the Steel Clan robot, in terms of articulation, he has a swivel in the shoulder, in the hips, and in the tail. He also has a rotation at this wing. That's it. Now, he does explode, but in order to do that, as I press the button here, he doesn't explode because he's too tight, so you want to loosen the head, and as you can see, that freed up the spring so you can launch him. So, I'll show you here. That would hurt like a motherfudger if you stuck that next to your head, so I recommend not doing it. What the heck? Probably had my finger on the button. So I'm going to put them together loosely, and then you'll get to see the exploding action that he has. So let me just do that quick. And as you can see, there he is, loose fitting, and as you can see, a lot more awesome when you do it, when you loosen up, or, the head especially. Where did that little piece go? Oh god, I feel like T-Biz right now. I'm missing my abs. I'm missing the abs, man. Oh crap. Okay. Where did that little sucker go? I got no freaking clue. Is it up here? No, it is not. It is. Quite missing, so I'm gonna stop here so I can find that, and I'll be right back. Guess we're back, and I found the abs that was over next to my bed. So, yeah, really powerful spring joint here. Mine might even be on the brink of just being a hair trigger. Ooh, that. Don't tell me mine's a hair trigger now, and it's not gonna stay. Yeah, this is a one to be careful with. I'm going to put them together behind camera. And, so any of you guys see any good movies lately? I saw Guardians of the Galaxy a couple of weeks ago. That was pretty cool. No, the Monster of Bloodbath Lagoon saw Sin City 2 twice. And he thought it was pretty dang good. He gave it an 8.9 in his review. Okay, I'm getting off topic. You know, it wouldn't be so bad if the joints weren't so tight on him. The joints are wicked tight on this one. One that you really don't want to screw with too much. So that's his gimmick. I'm not going to do it again because I don't need to go on a crazy hunt for missing limbs. Get in there, you little scutter. Oh, come on. Okay, let me try it behind camera. Yeah, these guys don't know what the word "hold your freaking accessories, you moron" means. Well, I should say phrase. But regardless, Steel Clan Robot's a cool figure. I like it. I think I gave him quite the high rating for being so accurate. I don't think his chest should have been this shiny silver. I think the face is fine as a silver, but I don't think the chest should have been. I think it should have been this flat gray like that is, and maybe his claws could have been silver. I don't know. I don't think they were really green in the show either. But, do I have them straight? No, I didn't. No, that could have been disastrous. But either way, that is the Steel Clan Robot. So I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Stay tuned. We're going to have a look at Cold Stone and then the Rip and Rider Cycle. And then we'll conclude Gargoyles Week and move into some other 90s figures like Mummies Alive and Skeleton Warriors. Until next time. So stay tuned for that. And until next time, I will catch you guys later.